Hello student, welcome to your economic class. Now we are going to start our first chapter and we will be learning the introduction. Human beings are intellectual creatures and thus they are able to group, distinguish and examine their surroundings and environment. To ensure a happy living, they have created various institutions like the social, political and economic. Let us learn the term economics. The word economics in India thought is Arthashastra, which is derived from the Sanskrit word Arth, meaning purpose or goal. And thus, Arthashastra in Sanskrit means the science of benefits or purpose in practical life. Now, as we are learning these concepts, let us understand the importance of the Indian culture. The four main pillars of Indian philosophy are Dharma, Arth, Kama and Moksha. Dharma means righteousness, duty. Arth, purpose, benefit, wealth. Kama means desire. And moksha means liberation. Kautilya has mentioned the importance of Arthashastra. That means, in our history, we had the term economics. As we learn further, we will understand the importance of the economic. The history of Indian culture is almost more than 5,000 years old, and thus Indian philosophy depicts various aspects of human life and provides insight into a way of life. Now we will learn the thoughts of economics as science in the West. First, let us see about Aristotle. He gives his views on economics in his book Economica, which has and developed as an independent science. Because with the advent of industrial revolution due to specialization, many changes occurred in the study of human behavior and economics developed as an independent science. Adam Smith, in the year 1776, he studied economics independently and in scientific manner. So, according to him, economic is the study of the nature and cause of wealth of nation. So, he says economic as social science. So, here he has introduced the term economic as a social science. Next, we have Alfred Marshall. In his book Principles of Economics, which was published in 1890, Alfred Marshall has defined economics is the study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. And he says that economics keeps human well-being at the center of human activity. And he explains how well-being is attained from material consumption. Next is Leonel Robbins. He has written the book Nature and Significance of Economics. And he has defined economic is a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce, means which has an alternative use. Resources satisfy human wants are limited and have alternative use. Hence, economics deals with the problem of allocation of scarce resource to satisfy the human wants to the maximum possible extent. Want only arises when there things are less scarce, so the demand increases. According to him, economic does not deal with norms and thus is not a normative science, but it is a positive science. Now, we will also learn about Paul Samuelson. He has published a book named Foundations of Economic Analysis. This was published in 1947. and he has studied how people in society end up choosing, with or without the use of money, to employ scarce productivity resources that could have alternative use. So, it analyses the cost and benefits of improving patterns of resource allocation. So, today we have just learned what are the thoughts about the economics by different people.